Are you annoyed by the endless stream of ads attacking you or your family from your computer to your phone or TV? They're basically everywhere. Is it even possible to get rid of them once and for all in your whole network, your whole house, so you don't need to set something on each and every one device? Good news, there is. And you can set it up to work with one device or your whole network in your home. Your choice. Stay with me. It's a piece of nifty little software named pihole. Back in the days when this project was created, it started as a piece of software for Raspberry Pi. Raspberry Pi is this little bad boy. It's a whole computer on one board the size of a credit card. It's cheap and it consumes very little energy. In years to come, pihole evolved to be the one easy to use solution to your ad problems. Nowadays, thanks to new technologies like Docker and pihole itself, you can run it on almost any kind of modern computer. The only condition is that this computer needs to be running whenever someone wants to use the internet, so basically 24/7 for all of us. That's why the power consumption is to be considered here. In short, technically speaking, pihole is a DNS server with huge block lists of ad servers that you deploy in your network and run your traffic through. Sounds pretty straightforward, and it is. But to understand what's happening here, let me walk you through it. When you open a web page, let's say cnn.com, the DNS or domain name system in your device and network will translate the cnn.com address to an IP address. The IP address is a representation of that address in numbers. Something like cnn.com translates to 151.101.195.5. Typically, ads on web pages are served from different URLs and servers, even if they appear on the same website. So when you introduce pihole to your network and open, for example, mentioned cnn.com, it will look into its vast database and translate all the ad-serving addresses or URLs to a numbered address that doesn't exist. Basically, sending those requests into a black hole. That's the name, pihole. In the end, your device thinks those ads don't exist and won't show them to you. It's a very simple idea, but an effective one. Compare these two images. On the left is the cnn.com homepage without pihole ad blocking, and on the right side with ad blocking. Let's count it real quick. One giant ad at the top of the page, another with a car, another with a bike, and another car. This whole section is missing, thus ad-related. Paid content, at least they admit it. Again, gone. And the last ad here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. At least 7 ads are right on the homepage. And I have no intention of digging deeper. I don't have to ask you which version do you prefer, do I? With the default configuration, pihole has over 213,000 of addresses in the block list. And you can expand it with more block lists. But even the default one is more than enough in my experience. Imagine, with a few clicks, all ads in your home are shut to hell. Not just your phone, TV2, kids' computers, tablets, everything. Of course, you can set it to work with only one device, but why would you do that? You can accomplish that in a different way. What I see as the main benefit here is the capability to safeguard your whole network. Okay, enough of theory. How can you make it work? Among other ways, there are two really easy ones. The first one is to install pihole the usual way on some hardware. If you have Raspberry Pi lying around, or you have, let's say, a Debian Linux server running in your home somewhere, or it can be a virtual machine, you can do it this way. Just hop to website pi-hole.net, hit install pihole, copy this one-liner command, and paste it into the terminal. It will take care of the installation of pihole for you. Can't be any easier. However, the way I like to handle my applications is through the containers and Docker. It's lightweight, clean, and solves a ton of things for me. But I'm not here to sell you Docker. By the way, it's free technology. Let me show you how easily I can deploy pihole using Docker and Portainer. I'll bet you I can do it under maybe a minute. You heard me right, let's do it. Okay, this is my homepage in my browser. By the way, it's called Heimdall and runs in Docker container. Check it out. Open Portainer, choose the device I want to run pihole on, Raspberry Pi 3B, stacks, add stack, name, pihole. Open pihole.net, hit Docker install, scroll up, copy quick start section back to Portainer, and paste it. Few changes, I don't want pihole to interfere with my DHCP. I like the web interface to be on port 8010. I'm in Europe, Prague, and set web password something quick, ASDF, ASDF. Deploy the stack. And that's it. You see, the container is starting, you can check its logs, and when the state says healthy, I can go to the IP address of this Raspberry Pi 3 on that 8010 port specified in the stack, and don't forget this /admin at the end. Look, just like that, pihole is up and running. I would lose the bet. It took me something around 2 minutes. I could have rushed it a bit more, but that's not the point. I can log in with ASDF, ASDF. Sure, you don't see much here, because no device in my network uses this instance. But we can poke around a little. You see the default block list contains more than 213,000 entries. And this is how it looks in my household. In the last 24 hours, 11,750 queries were blocked. That's 11,750 ad-related requests blocked for two adults using the internet here. Look at the proportion. 12.4% of all the traffic in my household is ad-related. That's crazy many. I bet you didn't even realize that. How much of your traffic is ads only? You can see some more metrics here, including top blocked domains and so on. Okay, remember this is the first part. We have pihole running. The second part is telling your devices or whole network to use this pihole as a DNS server. And this can be very different for many of you because all of you use different phones with different operating systems. The same goes for computers. Some of you use Windows, some of you use macOS, and some of you use Linux in many different flavors or distros. As I've said, in my opinion, the best way is to set it in one place, and that's the DHCP server or router in your network. That way, all the devices will use it. In my case, I open my router settings. I use pfSense for my router. Go to System, General Setup, set DNS server to the IP address where my pihole is running, and use remote DNS servers, ignore local DNS. I don't want it to serve anything it might remember from the time before pihole. Save, and services, DNS resolver, enable DNS resolver, enable DNSSEC support, and enable forwarding mode. This should be all, I think. Save and apply changes. And just like that, all the DNS queries in my network will be handed over to pihole and ads blocked. Now you can dig deeper into the pihole, fine-tune your settings and whatnot, but from this point forward, know that you will be spammed a lot less. With all the junk the internet is flooded with. If you want to know more about the hardware and software I used in this video, check out my other videos on Docker, Portainer, single board computers, pfSense and more. If this video helped you, please consider subscribing to my channel. It would help me a lot. Thank you guys. See you next time and bye.